Welcome back, guys, to La Casita's virtual kitchen. Very happy to see you all again, and thank you for joining us. So I'm really happy, really excited about today. We're going to make our salted caramel parfait. So don't be scared with this. It's quite simple. I'm going to go through step by step, and it's easy. So we've got 2 pans on the stove here. I'm just going to turn that on for you all. So in one pan on the left here, we have a stock syrup. So for this stock syrup, it's just equal parts sugar to water. This is basically designed to cook our eggs. So we've got some egg yolks in our mixer here. These have already been lightly whipped, so they go, instead of the yellow color, they go almost like a white kind of sort of nice thick texture. So our stock syrup is going to go into that later, and then in the right hand pan here we have our sugar for our caramel. So quite important when you're making the caramel is try to push or move or stir the pan as little as possible. You want it to have a nice even color and even melt, so we're going to leave that there. While that's happening down there, I'm going to talk through what we've got at the front here. So a caramel recipe is really basic, so effectively this here is just the sugar, some butter and a little bit of cream. This is double cream. It needs to be double cream for the purpose of cooking. Single cream isn't very good and it can split. So that's for the caramel. A little bit of salt. Obviously it is a salted caramel parfait, so this is just a molten sea salt. And then finally we've got a few gelatin leaves here, so the gelatin just going to help our parfait set. So all we're going to do with that straight away is we're just going to fold them in half so you hear a bit of a crack, and then just in a little bit of either ice water or cold water. Now the reason we do that is just to make it soft, so you can't put it in hard. It's almost like sheets of plastic, so you can't put them in like that, so we need to soften them first. And the idea behind the ice is basically to stop the gelatin breaking up as it's warming up. If it's in warm water, it will just disintegrate. So caramel's come up, the stock syrup's come up to the boil here. That's gonna be for the eggs. And then the caramel here, we're just waiting for that to sort of turn color. It's already starting to go around the edge. If you have a little look up there, you will see it's just coloring around there. So parfait is absolutely great. It's a very easy dessert to make. We make a variety of flavors at La Casita. We make a lot of fruit flavours which go down very well. It can be raspberry, it can be blackberry, anything like that. We also do different flavoured chocolate ones, so we do a chocolate orange, we can do a chocolate and coffee, we can do our white chocolate and honeycomb, which again is probably one of our best sellers. So you can smell this caramel because it's starting to turn. If you have a little look up here, it's starting to turn nicely now. So we don't really want to stir it now, we just want to let it do its thing, nice and easy. We also do sort of around the festive periods, we do different flavour parfaits. It's a very adaptable recipe. So one of our chefs has done a biscuit parfait, which is absolutely amazing. You can do a Bailey's one at Christmas, we do a Christmas pudding one at Christmas. We do like a caramel toffee one around sort of Halloween or bonfire night, and they all go down very well. It's probably a slightly lighter option in ice cream. It's an alternative, so there's lots of scope with these parfaits. The reason we had these on the menu at La Casita is basically to kind of fit into that vibe in these foreign countries, these Mediterranean countries where they have gelato. So instead of, you know, having a big heavy dessert, you can have a nice, fresh, almost palate cleansing parfait. So that's the reason we went there with these. And again, the variety of flavour, so it's very easy for us. This caramel now, if you have a little look, it's almost getting there, and so is the stock syrup here. So this stock syrup, if you have a probe, a thermometer, a sugar thermometer, you want to take this between sort of 115 and 121 degrees. We don't have one today, so basically I'm going to go by many parfaits, lots of practice. But you can see as it starts to get hotter, the bubbles get smaller and tighter. So you can kind of see. We don't want this to colour. So the caramel starts to colour, you've got a bit too hot. And what will happen is if you pour it onto your eggs, your eggs will probably just scramble. So we don't want that to happen. We're just going to turn that down a little bit. We're going to turn our, make sure our caramel is... So you can see now it's a real sort of dark, deep colour, but it's the last few little bits there. I am going to get a spoon ready. The spoon is going to help us when we come to add the other ingredients. So this is almost ready here, so we need to catch our caramel up. So we are going to go in with the spoon now just to get these last few lumps out. So there we go, we can have a little look over the top here. Now, when it comes to adding the other ingredients, just be careful. So the butter, because it's sort of cold, it might spit a little bit. So that's absolutely fine. You just need to keep stirring. So most of the lumps are gone now here. So we're gonna turn it down a little bit and then we're gonna add the butter. So we're gonna go in with the butter. All of it in. So at this point, we're okay to stir. Now, it will do funny things, so it might all clump together. Usually when you make a salted caramel or a caramel, once you add the butter, it will all come together, but we have had to change the recipe slightly just so the sugar intake basically makes a parfait set. It's too sugary, it will just be really soft and you won't be able to slice it. So at this point here, it looks like a bit of a split kind of butter and sugar mess. It will come together, do not worry. Keep going, keep stirring. To once all the butter's melted, okay? So once that butter's melted, we're gonna go in with our double cream, okay? So like this, this will bring it all together. So in with our double cream. Depending on how cold the cream is, this might make it look again a little bit funny, but just keep stirring, and as the heat gets into it, it will turn to a beautiful kind of silky caramel, which is exactly what we're looking for. So just keep stirring here. It will come together, I promise you. he says. Yeah, so if you have a little look now, it's starting to come together. So once all your cream is incorporated and it looks like a caramel that's all sort of, you know, a beautiful kind of togetherness. Just gonna boil it for about 10 to 15 seconds just to make sure. And then once we have done that, that's it, the caramel's done, so we can turn that off. We're just gonna give that kind of 10, 15 seconds to cool down now. So if you have a look in our other pan here, our stock syrup is nearly ready. So you can kind of see the bubbles are quite tight now, quite small. So again, we're probably gonna turn this off. You see it's still clear though, there's no color to it. So we're gonna turn that off now, and that's ready. And then the last thing we're gonna do with this caramel is we're gonna season it. So we've got our little salt here, tiny bit of salt. It does, the heat does bring the saltiness out, so if you put too much in it, it will be too salty. So we'll just mix that salt in there. Don't advise you stick your finger in to try it, but obviously feel free. I wouldn't recommend it though, it's obviously really, really hot. So we've got beautiful caramel here, if you have a little look. Lovely, silky, smooth. So we're just gonna let that chill for seconds, and then we're gonna bring our gelatin over here that we've soaked. So hopefully now you can see it's kind of a sort of jelly kind of softness. So we're just going to squeeze all the excess water out. So you just do that with your hands, give it a good squeeze, there we go, and then straight into the caramel. This needs to be obviously done when the caramel is still hot, but you don't want to be boiling the caramel, so that's why we let the caramel cool for even 1 or 2 minutes, so it's obviously not boiling anymore. You should never boil gelatin, it just doesn't set properly, it breaks it down and it's not effective. So you should see now, there's no little bits of gelatin floating around in there. We're all sort of a beautiful colour, an amazing smell, a beautiful caramel smell. So we're just gonna move that to one side, and that's gonna rest over there. And then, We're going to turn the mixer on here with our eggs in. So like I said before, these eggs have already been whisked probably for about 3 or 4 minutes just to get a nice air in them and turn them to like a whitey, creamy colour. So we're just going to turn this on. Put your mixer on quite high. What we're going to do with the caramel, we're going to pour it slowly into the eggs. Nice and slowly. After a little while, just keep it nice and slow. There we go. Use the pour the oil in. Again, it will probably overcook the eggs and it will probably get lumps of hard sugar in there. That's not what we want. So nice and slow. Last little bit here. So all of our caramel or all our stock syrup is now in the eggs. So what we need to do with this, and it's the same with all our parfaits, is we need to whisk this until it goes to room temperature. So if you hold the outside of the bowl, you can see it's really hot at the minute. So this usually takes between 8 and 10 minutes to get back to room temperature. It's really important that you do this, otherwise what will happen is your parfait won't set properly. So I'm going to leave this for the next 5 to 10 minutes and we'll be back shortly to finish off the rest of the recipe. I will see you soon. So welcome back guys. Okay, so now I'm just going to just going to turn the mixer off. Welcome back. So basically this has now had between sort of 8 to 10 minutes, whipped it nicely, it's cooled down now, so we're just going to lift it up. We're going to take out the whisk. So you have a little look in there. So with this eggs you should have almost like a perfect kind of really sort of clean shiny white texture. All the eggs have cooked out, that's all our air in there, so that's going to make our parfait really light, really sort of soft, really tasty. So just undo this. Okay, so also what I've got here is I've got some whipped cream, so this has just been lightly whipped. If you have a little look down in the bowl here, you can kind of see it's just starting to form really light ribbons. But it's still quite sort of thin. We don't want to go any further than that. So especially some of the other recipes, the white chocolate one, for example, it's actually a mousse-based recipe, so we over-whip our cream. When you come to adding everything together into the chocolate, it will just almost look grainy and split. So we don't over-whip our cream, that's absolutely fine. The caramel now, so what we're going to do, just one little thing about the cream is when we're making any form of desserts or cakes or anything like that, we want a nice, dry, clean bowl. If there's any water in there, it can just basically break everything down so you don't get like a real nice sort of finish. So everything's going to be in the end of here. In with the caramel, nice and slow. So we're just going to pour this into the eggs here. Nice and easy. Fold it in. So you should start to see that beautiful caramel colour. Smells absolutely amazing here. So just fold it in. Don't want to knock all that air out. You've just spent sort of 10 minutes getting that air in there. So the last thing you want to do is knock it all out. So just keep folding it in. either fold it in with a wooden spoon or a Maurice, they call it in the trade. It's just basically a sort of rubber spatula. So I'm just gonna get that last bit of the caramel in there. Go. So just fold this in now. Nice and fold it from the outside into the middle. And when you looks like it's all incorporated, so you don't really want that kind of ribbons running through it, all wants to be one colour. Don't want big chunks of kind of white in there, you just want like a nice sort of block colour. Just keep folding it until you're happy with it. And then what we're going to do, is we're going to go in with the cream. So again, similar sort of effect as you would with a caramel. Fold it in nice and easy. And because we haven't overwhipped our cream, when we're folding it through, it's not going to overwhip. It's not going to go too thick. So basically, the last little bit of cream here. Get the bowl scraped out. Put it all in there. So scrape that out there. Fabulous. So again, before, we're just folding it into the middle. Make sure it's all mixed up, give it a good mix. So you've got that beautiful sort of light caramel colour, but that, as it cools, as it freezes, that flavour will intensify and it will be absolutely amazing. So that's all mixed in there. If you have a little look in front, I've got two moulds. So these are basically just bread tins. I have lined them twice with cling film. So basically what we're going to do is we're going to pour the mix into them. We are going to fold it over so it doesn't get freezer burn on top. And then we're going to freeze these overnight. And what I will do tomorrow morning is I will come back to you guys. We will slice it. I'll show you how to serve it. And we might even do a little taste of it. So pour the caramel in right up to the top. So with this mix, you should get probably two of these tins. And between sort of, depends how generous you are, if you like a big wedge, between 8 and 12 portions per tin. In the restaurant, we just serve it with a little bit of a chocolate crumble and a little bit of fresh mint. So we've got our caramel in there. It's just every last little bit in there. And then I personally like it, so we'll just pull it up here so it's a bit closer to me. So we've basically overlapped these sides a little bit. So what we can do with them is we can fold it in, tidy up the edges a little bit. Just use your knife to fold it over nice and neat. There we go. So that's gonna sit in the freezer. Do the other one. There you've got two sort of nice and neat sort of caramel parfaits. We're going to sit them in the freezer. Like I say, it has to be overnight for this one. Some of the other ones you can maybe make in the morning and serve in the evening. The salted caramel, these ones, they do need that extra set time. So I'm going to pop them in the freezer. I will come back to you guys tomorrow and I will slice it for you, show you how to serve it. And like I say, we'll have a little taste of it. And that's it. That's like a Casita's salted caramel parfait. Dead simple, dead easy. Great for a dinner party to finish. Thank you again for watching and stay safe, stay well. Thank you, bye-bye.